The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Today there will be, at the end of our service, an act of remembrance, and where there will be a 2 minute silence, and where we'll be able to pray with one another for the peace of this world, and all those affected by conflicts, the past and past. In power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father.
Heavenly Giver of peace to the Church and to the world, we pray for Christians throughout the world, and particularly for those who are persecuted because of their faith. We ask for your protection for them, strength and guidance for all individuals and organisations that seek to help them. In the Anglican cycle of prayer today, we remember the Anglican Church of Mozambique and Angola, under the leadership of Acting President Bishop Carlos Batsine, for its people, and also for other churches with which we are associated, particularly today for the Estonian Evangelical Lutheran Church, under the leadership of Archbishop Põllumas Nõmme, and for its people. In this Interfaith Week, we pray for the work of the UK Interfaith Network, and for the strengthening of good interfaith relations at all levels. We pray for Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, for Bishop Jonathan, Bishop of Fulham, also acting as Bishop of Edinburgh, and in our parish for Julie and Andrew. We pray for our church leaders that they will be guided in their ministry by the influence of the Holy Spirit. Lord, in your mercy, bring peace to all places of strife and violence as we continue to pray for Ukraine, Israel, Palestine. Fill the hearts of those in authority with a true love for peace and the desire to work for harmony for those who seem to be their enemies. Bless those who are working in areas of conflict and being together in the name of Christ. We add our prayers for the staff and patients in the Anglican Hospital Al-Ahli in Gaza, the only hospital there providing good cancer care, and which thankfully continues to function despite an explosion from a misfiring rocket, and for the members of the Diocese of Jerusalem. Grant them spiritual strength in these difficult times. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for your blessing to be upon this congregation, upon this parish, and upon this church, and for your presence to be seen vividly in what we do and say each day. Grant peace and harmony, and help us as your church to reach out and shine your light into this community. Lord, in your mercy, have mercy on the victims of war, the wounded, and the refugees, and those who have lost everything they have. And as we pray for all who grieve at this time, and for those who continue to suffer the effects of wars, past and present, we give thanks for the work of the Royal British Legion, and all agencies who work to relieve stress and injuries sustained in war. We pray for those who we now name before you and who are mentioned in our pew sheet. John, Eileen, Lucy, Pauline, Sylvia, Gwyn, George, Francesca, Matt, Eileen, Theobald, Steve, Jill, Patrick, Brenda, Linda, Victor, and Caroline. For those recovering from surgery and undergoing treatment, may they feel the Father's love through the efforts of our prayers and the help of caring professionals. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for those who have died, and we remember those whom we hold in our hearts. We pray for those who are left behind, who mourn loved friends and relations. We bring before you Brian Hughes, recently departed, those whose years mine falls at this time. We give thanks for lives well lived and for happy memories. May they find rest in the eternal joy of heaven. May all who mourn their passing find comfort and peace. Lord, in your mercy, we hold before you those whose memories we cherish and those whose names you will never know. As we honour the past, may we put our faith in your future,
you are the source of life and hope, now and forever. Merciful Father,
our sacrifice to God,
for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
We meet in the presence of God. We commit ourselves to the work of penitence and faith for reconciliation between the nations. Let all people may together live in freedom, justice and peace. We pray for all who in bereavement, disability and pain continue to suffer the consequences of fighting and terror. We remember with thanksgiving and sorrow those whose lives in world wars and conflicts past and present have been given and taken.
May your grandmother, as we look at the world, may she not will your wills correct. At the word of God, the Son, and in the Lord, you will be
Leslie George Chanton, George Davis, Frederick Joseph Adams, Philip David Isa, Eric James Price, Victor Charles Cooper, Peter Owen Campbell, Charles Edward Radford, Arthur David Robbins, Gordon Ernest Derrick Evans, Bentinck Howard Cumberland, Cecil Howard Roberts, John Alan Gill, Arnold Gordon Hugh, Kenneth Victor Ritchie, Norman Eric Wright, Arthur William Price, Wilfred Bertram Stevens, Eric Christian Burke, Jeffrey Adrian Monbrew,
just future for all humanity.
Amen.
God, we offer